Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to change your default font in Adobe Illustrator. All right, let's get started. All right, first I'm going to open a new document. So I'll come over here to Create New. And now I'm going to choose one of these up here. And these are what decide what font is being used. So if you want the web one to always use a certain font, you can change only the web one. So I'm going to show you how to do that with web. But first I'm going to show you exactly what I mean. So I'll choose web, I'll choose common here, which is the first one, and then I'll create. And now I'll hit T on my keyboard and just draw a box. And this is the text I'm talking about. So this is Myriad, I believe. We got Myriad Pro at 12 points, it's black. So if we want to change this to something else, we'll have to change the document profile. On a Mac, we'll come out here to the Finder, and then I'm going to hit Shift Command H. That'll take me to Home, and you'll see Library here, but if you don't see it, just right click and choose Show View Options, then make sure this is checked here. Okay, so go to Library, Application Support, Adobe, find the version of Illustrator you're using. For me, that's 25, probably should get rid of all those others. And then go here to INUS, and then go to New Document Profiles, and we'll open the web one. Now on a PC, it is Users, User Profile, AppData, Roaming, Adobe, Adobe Illustrator 25 Settings, INUS, X64, and New Document Profiles. And I'll add this in the description below too. We've got the web document profile open. Now we can just go to Window, Type, and Character Styles. And that'll pull up this little window. You might have already had it open. Then we'll click this flyout, choose Character Style Options, and then click on Basic Character Formats. And this will give us the option of changing our font family. I'm going to go ahead and change this to Arial, and I'm going to make it a little bit bigger, maybe 20 points. You can see the other options you have. You can kern it in a little bit. You can change the leading and the tracking. We can also do horizontal vertical scale, and we can change the color here. So you can really get it exactly how you want it. Once you're done, just say okay. And then go ahead and make a text box here, and you should be able to see your new character style in your document profile. Just delete that and then save this. You might get this dialog box that says you can't save the illustration. I'm on a Mac and it's telling me the file is locked or in use, so I'm going to just say okay. Then I'm going to save as, and I'm going to get on my desktop and just save it out there as web.ai. We'll save it and say okay. And then I'll open up my Finder, go to my desktop, and here it is. And now I'll just drag it into that document profile's location that I showed you before. And it'll ask me if I want to overwrite, and then we'll replace. Let's go ahead and close all the documents and start by creating new. We'll go to web. I'll just choose common like before and create. And now if I hit T on my keyboard and draw a big box, I'll highlight some and check my characters. And this is Arial Regular 20, just like I had set it up. Now you should be able to completely close down the program and restart, and it'll still be saved in the web document profile. So let's go ahead and check it. We'll create new, we'll choose web, I'll do common, and I could really choose any of these as long as they're underneath the web option. We'll say create. And now if I hit T and make a box, yes, we've still got Arial Regular and 20 points. Now, a couple things to think about. Anytime you open old documents that you used with the web profile, those will update to the new font. So you need to be mindful of that. If you use that as actual text on something you created, it's going to change it. Also, if you want to update all of your document profiles, you'll need to go out to your Finder and open up all of these different ones and do that same character style replacement on all of them. But you only have to do it once, and they'll always be saved for you. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.